Today we're going to show you how to install a dripline irrigation system on a hillside. This is the most efficient way to water a landscaped hillside area. A dripline irrigation system eliminates the typical problems associated with sprinkler systems, such as runoff, evaporation, overspray, and wind drift, all of which can harm your landscape. The first step is preparing for installation. Let's get started. Before starting any kind of digging, be sure you know what's underneath the areas to be dug up. In most areas, calling 811 will get you to the right folks who can come out and mark the location of utility lines on your property, as shown in this clip. You can also call the local utility to have them come out. Be sure to call cable, water sewer storm, gas, phone, and electric. Now that you know where to safely dig, you're going to need a few tools. For this particular installation, we need the following: 100-foot tape measure, 2 adjustable pliers, shovel, rake, pipe cutter, 300 feet of Duraflow check valve tubing with 0.6 gallon per hour emitters and 12-inch spacing. Necessary 17 millimeter fittings to complete installation. This will be a combination of tees, elbows, and couplers. The amount of these will vary by installation. We recommend using the Agrifim Smart Lock fittings, properly sized PVC for header pipe. Follow manufacturer recommendations, PVC fittings for valve assembly and lateral line connections, 2 figure 8 flush connections, standard rectangular valve box for the drip valve and filter assembly. In order to determine your flow rate and spacing, you need to take the following steps. Firstly, you need to call your local location services hotline to have utility lines marked. You want to ensure that you don't disturb these lines during installation. Next, you'll need to take a soil sample from the installation area in order to figure out your soil type. The type of soil will help determine the emitter flow rate. Click here for more information about determining your soil type. Third, you have to measure the size of the turf grass area to be watered. This will help you determine how much dripper line is required for the job. Lastly, you have to examine the water supply. This will help you figure out two things: your water flow rate in gallons per minute and the pressure available for the installation. For more information on how to determine your flow rate and pressure, click here. For this example, the soil type was determined to be clay loam. The size of the planting area was 600 square feet, and the flow and pressure of the water source was 25 gallons per minute at 80 psi. This information will be used to determine emitter flow rate, spacing, and the total feet of tubing necessary. The dripline emitter flow rate, spacing, and lateral spacing is determined based on your soil type. This residence has clay loam soil. Using this chart, it was determined to use 0.6 gallon per hour emitters spaced at 12 inches with a lateral spacing of 18 inches. To determine the total feet of tubing necessary, we'll use this equation. Take the area of your hillside and multiply it by 12 inches. Then take that number and divide it by the lateral spacing to get the total feet of tubing. For this residence, the area of the hillside is 600 square feet, and the lateral spacing in inches is 18, which equals 400 total feet of tubing. Next, we need to calculate zone flow. Zone flow is used in conjunction with your water source capability to help size your irrigation valve, drip filter, and regulator. Total zone flow equals the total feet of tubing times the flow per 100 feet divided by 100. To figure out your flow per 100 feet, reference this chart. For this example, the flow is based on 0.6 gallons per hour and 12-inch spacing, which equals 1.0 gallon per minute. The total zone flow for this particular residence is 400 feet multiplied by 1 gallon per minute divided by 100 feet, which is 4.0 gallons per minute. Based on this residence's total zone flow of 4 gallons per minute, and the water source capability of 25 gallons per minute at 80 psi, it was determined to use a 1-inch valve and Agrifim's pressure regulating Y filter. For this application, a 1-inch electric solenoid valve was selected. You will need a 1-inch PVC male adapter on the inlet side of the valve and a 1-inch PVC female adapter on the outlet side of the valve. Follow these steps to create the assembly. Teflon tape all threaded connections on the PVC fittings and pressure regulating filter. Connect the 1-inch PVC male adapter to the inlet side of the valve. Connect the inlet side of the pressure regulating filter to the outlet side of the valve. Connect the female adapter to the outlet side of the pressure regulating filter. Tighten all fittings with the adjustable pliers to ensure they are leak-free. Locate an area for the drip irrigation control valve as close to the center of the landscape area as possible. Dig a hole large enough to allow adequate room for the installation of a standard valve box. Connect the valve assembly to the main line of the irrigation system. For more details on how to install a valve box, click here. Follow manufacturer recommendations to properly size the PVC header, 1 inch in this case. Measure and cut your pipe to lengths to create the proper lateral spacing, 18 inches in this case, and install service tees between the sections of pipe for the lateral drip lines. Wrap Teflon tape around the threads of the adapters and install them into each service tee. Connect the header to the outlet side of the drip irrigation valve and pressure regulating filter assembly. Cut sections of 17 mm blank tubing long enough to reach the desired grade of the lateral lines and install them to the barbed portion of the fittings. Make sure the tubing goes completely over the second barb and rests at the stop point on the fitting to ensure a leak-free connection. Backfill the header pipe trench to the desired grade. Measure out equal lengths of 17 mm drip line to cover the entire length of the planting area, 75 foot lengths in this case. Connect a tee to each of the feeder lines from the header so that the top of the tee is at grade. For best results, we recommend using Agrifim Smart Lock Tee. Start at the top of the hillside, line up the tubing so it covers the entire length of the planting area, and cut the tubing at the proper location to connect both sides to the tee connection. Staple the tubing every 3 to 5 feet to maintain the proper lateral spacing throughout the planting area. Repeat this process for the remaining lateral lines in the planting area. Use the same drip line tubing from the laterals to connect the lateral lines on each end of the zone pipe. Cut pieces of tubing to length, 18 inches in this case, to connect the laterals. Ensure you maintain the intended spacing between them. Use Agrifim Smart Lock fittings to connect the laterals together at the end of the planting bed. Now that the lateral lines and header pipes have been installed, it's time to install flush points. Locate them at the low point on both ends of the zone. Connect an 8 to 12 inch piece of tubing to a T connection at the end of the zone. Slide the figure 8 all the way onto the tube. Kink the tubing 6 inches away from the tee and slide the other side of the figure 8 onto kink tubing until it holds the kink firmly in place. Select your desired ground cover mulch and place a 2 to 3 inch layer uniformly over the planting area.
So there you have it, an easy way to install drip irrigation on a hillside that will save you both time and money and will give you the highest efficiency possible for your landscape irrigation. This particular installation shows how effective Dripline can be in watering a hillside. Its slow, targeted application of water virtually eliminates the typical problem of runoff and can be made to work in all soil types. In addition, it applies water directly to the plant's roots, resulting in the healthiest, best-looking plants possible. For more information on this and other NDS drip irrigation products, check out our other videos.
For more than 30 years, NDS has been a leader in water management solutions for the residential and commercial markets. For more information on our other drip irrigation solutions and special offers, go to ndspro.com.